after the very first Python program went out, this is a story George tells, he sent a letter to the BBC after the first program, which was by no means a success. It was sort of, you know, very much on the edge. And George had sent a note to say that he thought it was great. And we never got the note.
Life can be fine if we're both 69, if we sit on our faces and all sorts of places to play till we're blown away.
And that I'll is kind of, that's before. I'll, is let my lips embrace you. I'll sit and face and tell you.
I'll sit in your face and then I'll love you truly. Life can be fine if we're both 69, if we sit on our faces and all sorts of places to play till we're blown away.
I love to.
It was just the thought of doing it at the Albert Hall. It was just too great a moment to not take advantage of. After the beautiful Indian music, to lower the tone considerably, to let him know the heights and depths of George's taste.
Transcends all previous specialnesses. We had to do the build into it, and it seemed to just be nice. It was kind of, it all dealt with what the evening was. And it wasn't, it absolutely wasn't about people saying, this man who changed my life, this wonderful person, this saint, which would have been completely wrong. That George would have really hated.
Bigness of someone so hugely big in our little lives that his bigness and our littleness are like opposite stars of a stellar. I didn't want to do this anyway. I don't want to go to tributes all my life. I wanted to be homosexual. Leaping from man to man as they float down the mighty rivers of British Columbia. The policeman, the plumber, the mighty traffic warden, the little church hall organizer. Oh no, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, sorry. I'm going to be a lumberjack leaping from tree to tree as they float down the mighty rivers of British Columbia. The giant redwood, the larch, the mighty, the fir, the mighty Scots pine.
We come in.
The smell of fresh cut timber.
Let's get a position.
The crash of mighty trees. With my best girl by my side, we'd sing, sing, sing. Oh, I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day.
So we ended up doing the lumberjack song, which was a big favourite of George's. Indeed, he used to have a forwarding address. He used the alias Jack Lumber somewhere in Hawaii. But anyway, he loved lumberjacks. I said, yes, we'll do that. You know, I'll write all these things that would merely make George squirm, and then we can undercut them and go into the lumberjack song. But it's a good idea of Terry's.
He sleeps all night and he works all day.
Gotta make up my ass. There's that special makeup artist coming. Yeah, it's a very specialised work making up your ass. You know, there's not many people who do that job. It takes a special kind of guy. You're reading a travel magazine? That's a bit ironic, isn't it? Michael Palin seen reading a travel magazine. One that he's not in, which is a very rare thing.
Michael Palin, where next?
Where next? Where next? Do I go next?
It just has to be an Arab. It's about Van. Les Van.
Around there.
It's
going to go around.
Constantly thinking of George up there and what he would have wanted, and probably wouldn't have wanted the thing at all, you know. Just come on and fall over a bit.
Personally grated. These are grated by El Grato from Turin.
Grate
my shoes because they're new shoes and very slippery surface. And if you fall off a stage in the Albert Hall, what an idiot you would feel.
The socks that I've got for you are somewhat longer.
I think the side looks quite good.
Yeah.
Kerry, do you think suspenders have them at the side? Do you want to try?
That's very bizarre because that's the way I always want to do cartoons with those.
Yeah,
I'm on the side.
The side is fine.
The side? Yeah, yeah.
Is that enough? It's quite nice when we bow.
The bottom audition, you know, for the sit on my face and a lot of laughing about when the bottom should be revealed.
Stand still.
Oh my God.
I think Terry had his bottom out long before it was necessary.
It's a job, I suppose. Yeah. Wait a minute, it isn't a job.
You know, it's an important thing to moon the Albert Hall. How many people have had a chance to moon the Albert Hall after they're 60 years old? Four of us.
this is a bit tight.
Men's legs with garters are really
classic. These are Scottish knees.
The Freds are sort of in a dressing room. They'd quite like to just hear how we're going to end it and all that. So I get them to come in.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day.
He's a lumberjack and he's okay. He sleeps all night and he works all day.
I cut down trees, I eat my lunch, I go to the lavatory. On Wednesdays I go shopping and have buttered scones for tea.
He cuts down trees, he eats his lunch, he goes to the lavatory. On Wednesdays he goes shopping and has buttered scones for tea. He's a lumberjack and he's okay. Sleeps all night and he works all day.
I cut down trees, I skip and jump. I like to press wildflowers. I put on women's clothing and hang around in bars.
He cuts down trees.
I got on the phone to Fred Tomlinson just after he'd written it. And I said, Fred, you know, if I kind of hum this to you, can you put some music to it? And they were they'd done some, he's a lumberjack, they'd always done spam, 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 wonderful spam, 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 lovely spam, lovely spam. They do these harmonies, you know, that was the Fred Toms, very, very, very important, and they vital to Python.
Let's just take you four guys on first.
Yes.
We'll leave the Toms like on the side for a moment.
We'll leave you. The moment has come, and jolly,
we'll,
jolly.
We'll try and run this in real time if you want to.
We would like,
because we'd like to do our change.
If we don't,
we won't know our change.
I'd just like to do step by step. Yeah. If we don't run into the time, I don't think they'll quite appreciate what you're trying to do.
Which is very difficult.
That's quality, isn't it? That's quality.
That is the quality.
Thank you.
Now, what was always embarrassing with him was he knew everything backwards and forwards with Python, and he'd throw out a line expecting you to come back with whatever the response should have been. I didn't know what he was talking about half the time, and the Python stuff actually became really tedious after a while. Him and his love of Python.
And as they go there, applause will carry them all the way there.
But if you old buggers can't get changed in a minute and a half,
I know you've got to put all sorts of medical equipment on and things like that.
Get the pants on is what we have to do. That's going to take all the time in the world.
And then there's all that. All
you can just busk.
Busk in the Albert
Hall. Busk in Albert Hall. Yeah, you can do it, Mike.
Well, while I've got you all here, I'd like to draw your attention to my next appearance in the Blue Water Shopping Mall.
Yeah, you can sign books.
A week from now. Mike told me you'd said find a copy that wasn't signed.
No, I told my driver, I said I found a very rare unsigned copy of your book. Which is worth a lot, actually.
So there we were in the room together, and it was really a very, very nice, one of the best Python experiences. A lot of laughs, and everyone was on very good form, and I think there was a real feeling that it was going to be a special evening.
15 minutes to go.
Set your watches, 15 minutes.
Terry, watch out for that kettle.
Watch anybody? Yeah, we're not watching my
No hitting embarrassments.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, I'm ready.
That would just be a private affair.
No.
A little Python reunions where things get...
That was certainly the first time we'd all done, or four of us had done Lumberjack song for a long, long time, with Tom Hanks standing in for John Cleese. Fair trade-off, I thought. John won't work again.
A little tuck done.
I was thinking of having a little tuck.
Yeah.
What do you think?
No, I think just all your bottoms are absolutely fine.
Really?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. Thinking a bit of lipo. So they're having a bit sucked out of here and put in here.
Is it becoming incredibly hot in here?
They needed the perfect bridge between the Indian band and the electric
band.
See, what would be good?
Yeah.
Poetry? Photo montage? Racing cars barreling through.
It's it, boys. Good luck, Tom.
I'll meet you in the hall.
Returning right.
I'll be following you, but I promise I won't lose you.
Thanks.
You feel that buzz out there, and then they go up and whoosh! The whole place just blew open. It was fantastic.
From the sublime of the Indian music to the utter ridiculousness of, you know, 60-year-old men mooning and singing. There was, yeah, a lot of love in that room. It's again hard to describe that night because it seemed so brief, and yet you kind of want to hold on to it. The sense of it, the audience, the people on stage were just, there was no seriousness in the sense. It was, George wasn't serious in that way. I think he would have despised us all getting up there and saying some of the things that are said at other people's dues.
This is a very special night.
I think because it was for George, you know, that really made us feel, it was so different from the fact that, you know, just doing it for lots and lots of money for a producer and got a reunion together. I mean, it was just, that's what made the atmosphere so special for all of us. And everyone was terribly elated at the end of it.
Harry! Oh, no, wait, Harry, you've got to... What? You've got to... Oh, God.
Yeah, okay.
It's a lonely man on stage, isn't it? Sad and lonely man. Yeah.
I wanted to be a lumberjack! Leaping from tree to tree as they float down the mighty rivers of British Columbia!
You know, there'd been a year to people get themselves back together, and then you wanted to go on and on and on. I was really a bit disappointed that it had to end. And I think everybody felt the same thing, because we're having such fun, and it was all for him.
With my best girl by my side, we'd sing, sing, sing.